Alright, welcome back to Silent Fighter Gaming, guys. We are playing some more Demon Souls. We're continuing on where we left off. We just defeated the Adjudicator, Dictator, whatever you want to, however you want to pronounce it, boss. So we're going to the next segment in the Shrine of Storms. Now you can shoot these stingrays, but I hate this stupid thing. I don't waste my time with them and my arrows. I can't even remember what that was, but it's not important. So we're gonna go in here now. See, they just now shoot at me and I'm not even out there. Way too much crap. There's this guy again. See?
Hello there. We meet again.
You look terrible. Cheer up. Life is an adventure.
So you can buy some more stuff with him. I think he adds kunai now, which wasn't there before. I don't remember. You can buy some of that stuff. Yeah, I think it's a few more added stuff than there was last time. Yeah, fire. This guy's the only one that sells fire arrows, I believe, and holy arrows. Holy arrows are straight magic, which is what the skeleton gods fire. Fire arrows do physical and fire, which is good. Light arrows are just light physical. Wooden arrows are a little bit lighter. Regular arrows are just actually surprising. Okay, the wood arrows and the regular arrows are the same. That's weird. Never actually paid attention. Okay, wait, let me see if there's any difference. Okay, longer flight distance in the stand. Okay, so the only difference is they have more range. Which is a big help. So. And you still have the same armor as before. So yeah, he doesn't really say anything new, but.
Somebody I ought to warn you about, a fellow who lacks common decency. They call him Patches the Hyena.
Oh, yeah.
And he's the one that laid that trap for me. He's the kind of person who'd stab his mother in the back. If you happen to spot him, you'd be doing us all a favor by putting him out of his misery.
Yeah, this is where you first see Patches. He is actually down here. So we're going to deal with him. This is kind of a cool area. Got a Grim Reaper down there. I have his weapon, it's pretty cool. So basically, you can sit here and farm these guys forever and keep getting souls from them. He summons these, like, invisible golem looking guys. They don't do that much damage, but don't find out. Now, if you're a lower level in the game, they do deal a lot of damage. But someone like me, it doesn't do bad. I'm not gonna find out. See, and they poise through your attacks. So they do not stagger ever. I don't have my ring of regen on. And if whatever ones exist, they can morph into another area. So, one will eventually show up here if I hang around long enough. Yeah, like this guy. This weapon's not fast enough to pull three attacks off. Now, if I had the Gudachi Katana out, it would probably kill him before he's able to take his first swing. Oh, he totally missed. What an idiot. But yeah, they just keep coming and coming. Like, he'll keep spawning more and more. And you can just sit there and farm them. They're really slow. They're easy to evade. So.
Man,
hate the narrow wall really prevent your swing from going out the hallway. So let's go get rid of this guy before. Yeah, he does shoot magic out. Really, guys? So he gives you like what, almost 8,000 souls, and then they give you a bunch. Whatever guys are left standing up, you actually get all of them. So that was like 608 times however many were standing around. That's how many souls I just got. Plus him yet. I don't even know what that is, but it's no big deal. I'll just pick up what I can carry, and which ain't much, and more than what I have already. See, I have too much crap. He drops dark moonstones, which I have plenty of, usually. They do come back. They are not one-time spawns, and like if you kill them, and then they don't ever come back. No, they still come back. Per place, like every time you die or whatever, come back to this area, they will come back. So we just came from here. Let's go over to these other set of steps first before we do something. Oh yeah, I think it's. No, this isn't the doorway. It's the one above here. Well, let's go to the very top first. It's that doorway there, but we're gonna do this first. Oh, watch out. Yeah, I can always use those. Invisible wall. Now, first couple playthroughs in this game, I never even knew that existed. Oh, this is a nice guy. Oh my god, I can't believe how much health he has. Oh yeah, that wasn't cool. Don't want to get too close to him. Oh my god, him stupid stingray, that hurt that. Regen stam. Let's go. Alright, buddy. I don't like you. You're annoying. Oh wow, he totally missed. So now, if you're close enough to the edge, he sometimes jumps back when he evades me. He jumps back and like actually falls off. It's pretty funny. Yeah, there's a little path down here. I think there's a lizard over here. Oh yeah. These lizards always have too much health. See, like, you gotta have, like, that good of a sword to freaking kill him right away. I mean, something that almost insta-kills him. And this is a good sword, too, which, by the way, I want to explain real quick. Let me go inside somewhere first. Oh, this is, what was this over here that they give you? It's a good item. Ha, funny, I don't even know. It's a weapon. I already have it. I just can't remember what it was. Over there is where we first entered from the Arkstone. So you can hear it. Up there was the last boss we fought. Down there was before the boss. That's where we fought the yellow guys, I believe. So where am I at? Oh yeah, there we go. Oh no, wait, I'm an idiot. This is where we came from. But we are above where we were out before the other boss. Yeah, that's way down there. If you see that, it did show that flag there, down there, that flag. That's where we were at before the boss. Okay, this sword is a really good sword. It was a, well, I'll show you in the, well, I think it, I might have said it, shown it in the Nexus video. This is called the Northern Regalia. It's a combination of the old King Allen final boss weapon and the guy I was explaining in the Boletarian Palace Part 1 video. The guy you have to unlock with the key. you have to fight him. The guy I also got this armor from, he holds this other weapon that's similar to the other one. You can merge them, infuse them both together, and it creates this weapon, which is, like, really powerful. It's a really good, like, medium speed weapon, but it's I think it's considered a great sword, but it swings, like, medium swings. So, it's not bad. Okay, if we go into here, which is where all them lights are, there's your buddy Patches. Of course, he's twisted as usual. I mean, I didn't have to do this, but just to show you.
Don't hold it against me, eh? Take your time starving to death. Then I'll sell every last trinket off your corpse.
Little jerk off. Oh, here's where I saved the one guy. He goes to the shrine. Of course. I think I've only got that item once from up there, and you have to do something to get it to come down. Alright, let's talk to this guy. He's the miracle guy in the shrine. The main miracle guy.
Heavens, did you fall for that little devil's trap? Well, I did the same. He fooled me, and now I am stuck here. The reverberation seemed to suggest that we are connected to the outside. But dark, fearsome souls stand between us and freedom. But have no fear. God will cleanse us of evil. Pray with me. Umbasa.
Umbasa.
Heavens. Well, yeah, we're but okay. Pray with Umbasa.
Okay, so he goes back to the Nexus then. So I'll do a future video later when I pretty much send everybody back to the Nexus to show you, you know, what that's all about. But yeah, you're able to buy, like, the main miracles off of him. That I believe. Yeah, so. This guy. He has bleed weapons. So this is what a Red Phantom looks like, they call them Black Phantoms. They're actually, yeah, before they made the Dark Soul games, they called them Black Phantoms in this game. See, they are black with the red highlations with them. Oh, shoot. With a red outline. You could have helped me, dude, instead of standing there, throw some magic at him. What, that actually hurt him doing? Yeah, that actually hurts him doing that. See, it hurts him when I block. That's crazy. Does 83 damage. That's pretty good for not doing anything. Bye-bye. God, I can't pick anything up. I pretty much maxed out anyway with a lot of the crap, you know, like 96. Now those aren't like I can still get those, but all right. Well, in the inventory back in the Nexus, I have 99s of like almost everything. So I'm like forced to carry all them shards. I should probably make a bunch of weapons just to get rid of them. Stuff I already have. So now I go through here. Now, you can choose to talk to Patches and he apologizes to you like he does in all the games. Or you could fight him. He's actually really tough in this game. He's easier in the other ones, but he's really hard to beat in this one. And I also have that shield. That's the I want to call him the Adjudicator, but I think it's the Adjudicator. Dictator or something. But that's his shield. And now he didn't use it as a boss when he was a boss, but that's that shield's name after him. Yeah, it even has his picture on there. See that? Basically, while you have that out, your health regens. So that's also why he's hard. Patches hits hard, he defends hard, and he regens health. So if you choose to fight him, I would do a cheap shot and stab him in the back, and then just do the best you can. I've actually died already fighting him.
You.
But he goes back. He goes back to the Nexus and sells you stuff.
I didn't mean to say it.
broken man's got to make a living, right? Here, look. I can make up for it. There aren't many humans like us. We need to stick together. I know. Here, take this as a token of my friendship. You've seen one of these before, surely.
Ring of gash resistance. Yeah, that's basically your bleed resistance. Slows bleed down. Chances of bleed, whatever you want to call it.
Come on. Let's be friends. What do you say? No need to drag each other down. No need to drag...
So now he goes back to the shrine. You can buy stuff off of him. So, yeah, this is patches in the game. You won't see him anymore. He does show up in another area, too. I remember now. I can't remember. I think it's in Stonefang Tunnel. I think he shows up. I'm not sure. It's not the Tower of Latria, because I would remember. And it's not Valley of Defilement, from what I understand. Now, I think it's Stonefang Tunnel. Yeah, it is, because he does another trap to you, I believe. Fun. I just love the running in this game. It's awesome. So this looks like the original spot where the stingrays would launch. See, there's like dead ones laying around here. Now, when I was off camera in the past, I used to like sit here and shoot the stingrays a lot, but it gets annoying after a while. It takes too long. You waste arrows. So now, obviously you can't... Okay, I guess he does do that. There was times already where I had trouble walking up here, but now it lets you, apparently. Alright, so I'm gonna... The good thing is about me having the thief ring on, they're not shooting at me right now. Hopefully they don't. Stupid. That thing barely misses. Alright, this is the easiest way of getting rid of these guys. Yeah, you can let him do that too. The other guy, I'll show you a funny trick that'll kill him right away. It's actually pretty hilarious. I hope it works. I'm trying to remember if this is the one. Yeah. Just rolls right off the cliff. He doesn't even care. Look at these two juggernauts down there. Now, if I keep shooting him, he will find me eventually. I just thought he was going to run into it. These guys got tough health. Are you really that stupid? Alright, dude, let's go. This is doing a little bit more power than Yuchi Katana. Alright, let's fight this guy the whole way. No arrows. Oh, not good. That didn't do anything to him? That's not good. I'm so glad them stingrays ain't shooting. I'd be pissed right now if it did, because then I would have died. There's a certain way you gotta use that God's Wrath. I don't know why it didn't hit him. Okay, well, one of his moves, it does poise through my attacks. Apparently he wasn't set up for that. It's one of his two-handed attacks. Like, I can hit him and he still manages to pull through it and swing. Alright. This part's a little tricky. I don't like it. I think I'll be alright, though. These guys, like, some of the ones with the glowing face, like to shoot the, hold on, I can't talk while I'm trying to evade them. Shoot a beam out. I already knew where this guy was hiding. And then he just falls to his death. Okay, so the guys with the glowing face, like the one eye or whatever, like the Cyclops or whatever, they shoot a laser beam out. The regular ones don't. At this point, there is no more regular ones. Ah! Stupid bitch. Alright, hold on a minute. Okay, they usually don't show up right away, but apparently she did. There's like these smaller female ones that show up. You hear them laughing when you don't have them on. Yeah, when you go over here is when they show up. See? Yeah, she really messed me up. The other one did. You at, woman? One crescent moon dress. Come on, where are you at? So I'm guarding the weakest health. Or you're guarding the weakest health in this area. Don't tell me you just went away. There's at least four of you, and I killed two of them. Did they just literally disappear? Alright. I don't hear them laughing now. They must have just disappeared. Alright, that's a new thing. Okay, somebody died. Alright, what do we got over here? Nobody. Now, okay, now, here's something that I remember. Here's a perfect time for me to explain myself. Remember in the Nexus video I was explaining about the Black World tendency for not the person, and the world. If this area was completely black, the Shrine of Storms, okay, it's neutral right now. So I could actually pull off, I only need to do that like two or three times. Like, remember I kill myself and then use a Stone of Ephemerical Eyes every time? And it becomes black. Remember I said about these black phantoms that would show up? Well, right here, this spot here, the black phantom samurai sword guy shows up here with it, like facing this way, like this. And he's really tough. His health is doubled compared to what he has. And you guys saw what his health is already like. So this is the type of guy, like if I spawn at the boss fight, which is up here yet, if I spawn there and then come back and then get behind him, they can use the Soul Sucker spell and just kill him like instantly, practically. This is also the guy that I have to farm. Also, in the Black World tendency, mind you, I have to farm this guy for the pure Dark Moonstone or the Blade Stone. I forget, it was one of them too. To max out that build. It's that one and then a Marrowstone chunk from the other world is where I get the, And then I'll get the weapon trophy of getting all the weapons in the game infused. Come on! Okay, I thought this guy was like a laser beam one. Alright, so, but yeah, you have to farm this guy, like, literally either you can kill him on the first try and it shows up, or you can sit here for 10 hours doing it. It's so random. It's probably my luck is so horrible, that's probably why. My luck is terrible. He's just walking, okay. I heard that, so there is one over here somewhere. Yeah, I kind of figured. The best way to attack him is to use the power attack in a narrow spot like this. Now before he spawns anymore. He's right here. These guys are so cool looking. I wish they put more. This is the only three in the game. So I just killed them all now. That was all of them. Oh, and from above, up there, is where I killed the last one that was standing there. He fell down here and died. I believe that was the ledge or higher yet. I'm not sure. So we're down through here. This is a kind of an annoying spot, but it's not too bad. I can actually level up now. I have enough to level up. Alright, so you gotta end this area here. This is where the slugs started to come into play. Alright. Now, if you're like in the Dark Souls and stuff, you noticed, and I know Dark Souls 3 has the slugs. I forget if 1 and 2 have them. I don't think they do, but 3 does. This is where they originated from. They also are in Valley of Defilement. They're not lighted like these ones are, like incandescent or whatever. The ones in the other level are just regular colored. Also, these magic beams, you want to watch out. If you wanted to blow them up so it doesn't like hurt, like so you don't run into them while you're down there, you can just go up to one up here and then just roll out of the way. It's like a, but the, yeah, see, then you get rid of them then. So let's go kill these guys. Yeah, they do just throw crap at you. This is also a spot where you can farm sticky white stuff. So if you don't want to buy them, this is the place to farm them. Alright, so that was it down here. So you got that, them over here, and you got these. Ow, ow. These guys suck. There's one. Ah! Get out of here! That's not even... See, this is why I like blowing them things up there. I should have died right there. I'm so glad I didn't. I need to go destroy those things out in the open. Because they do go through the walls, and if you're not careful, and you're in a tight spot, like I was fighting them stupid slugs while that thing blew up. I could have been in a worse situation. I have so many of them things, I don't care if I overuse one. Ronin's ring, and then something else. It's a weapon. I have triplets of every like freaking ring. Shard of Sucker Stone. That's another type of shard. The only thing about this game that you can't do is the weapon arts, like in Dark Souls 3. That's a new added feature. The way this game was, this is all like just your like basic attacks and basic strong attacks. You could
your running attacks are usually just slams. They're not like spins like the Dark Souls games. So, but it doesn't make the game boring. It's still real, a lot of fun, even when there's no weapon art. So. Wow, really? I can't stand it! Oh my god. Not enough room to downswing, and I can't freaking regular swing. Dude, oh my god, that was so close. That should have hit me. I don't know why that didn't blow up. Let's just say I'm lucky. I'm meant to beat this. Sticky white stuff. Well, hello there. I'm going to hide in the corner. I could probably take the thief's ring off. Put the regen one back on. Oh, where to go now? This area is almost cleared. There's only like two like ramps to walk up. Here's one. Let's get rid of these stupid things up here. Really? Alright, so we have a couple choices here. This one's more narrow right there. Let's do it. Dude, that thing just went right by me. I don't know why that didn't hit me there. Now, if I'm full health, I can get away with surviving one, but when I was fighting those other slug that time, oh my god, I should have died. I literally should have died. Yay, I need this. That was close. I think I got everything I needed. I mean, other than stuff laying around that I can't pick up. I don't need any of that either. And that just hangs around there. There's no importance of that at all. So and then up here is the next boss. So thanks for watching Silent Fighter Gaming. Tune in for the boss fight.